Hello and welcome to the Choosing Happy podcast. I'm your host, Heather Masters, and today we're diving deep into a journey that many of us face at the moment, moving from anxiety to happiness. We're in chaotic times around the world, so stay tuned for tips around moving from anxiety to happiness, feeling relief in your world. That and more in this week's Choosing Happy podcast. Have you ever felt like anxiety was a dark cloud constantly looming over your life? Have you ever really felt it in your body where you're constantly focusing on the things that could possibly go wrong? You're living in a fearful state, almost like you're living in dread most of the time. And you're not alone. Millions of people worldwide struggle with anxiety. But here's the thing. It doesn't have to be a permanent state. Today, we're going to explore how to transform those anxious feelings, that dread, into genuine happiness. So let's start with a personal story. I cared for my parents for 4 years, and every day I was on high alert. I was anxious because both of them were very, very ill and towards their end of life. And I constantly had to be aware to make sure that they weren't falling over, that there wasn't something going wrong with either of them. It was so much so that I couldn't take a shower without ensuring I wasn't going to be called for or something wasn't going to go wrong. And after living in that state for such a long time, anxiety became a habit. I was on high alert most of the time. And I noticed this after they both died and I moved in by myself. I was even struggling to give myself that time to go have a shower, even though there was nothing else around me. That anxiety had become a habit. It had become embedded into my story, into my day. So now let's break down how we actually move out of that. Because anxiety, after all, is something about living into a negative future story. It's something that hasn't happened yet. Yet putting all of that energy into it not only takes away from the present moment, takes away from our lives now, it actually helps create the negative experience that we're worrying about. It kind of attracts it to us. And even if you don't believe in energy, it's your reticular activating system of your unconscious mind looking for those negative events to occur, because that's where your focus is. So let's break down this transformative process and to three steps, three ways that you can move out of anxiety and into happiness, or even into a present state where you can choose, you can make the choice of how you want to feel. Now, the first thing is awareness. And the first step in any change is recognizing and acknowledging the problem. So acknowledging you're anxious, acknowledging you're living constantly in dread, or acknowledging it's temporary anxiety, and acknowledging that anxiety is a future focused problem and the future hasn't happened yet. So we have the ability to do something about it. So we'll discuss how to identify anxiety triggers and patterns in your daily life. Acceptance is number two. Fighting anxiety often makes it worse when you're trying to block it down. So we'll explore the power of accepting your feelings without judgment and how this can be a turning point in your journey into choosing something different. Number three is action, and we look at this area where the real transformation happens. We'll dive into practical strategies to shift your mindset, including mindfulness techniques, cognitive restructuring, and lifestyle changes that promote happiness. Remember, Choosing happiness doesn't mean you'll never feel anxious again. It means you're committed to working through those feelings and actively cultivating joy in your life. Now, let's get into the nitty-gritty of each of those strategies. So for awareness, being willing to acknowledge where you are is the first step. Really sitting in your reality. Often we can find ourselves in denial, or we're so anxious that we are actually unaware that we're anxious. So for me, being in that constant state of high alert, I hadn't realized it would carry over, that I'd become such a habit that it would carry over once all of the things that I was anxious about, all those high alert incidents, had left. So it took me a while to become aware and to notice my behaviors and my patterns. So I was thinking about everything. I was second guessing myself all of the time, and really, you know, still questioning whether I had the time, whether it was safe enough. What was the consequence of me taking the shower? What was the consequence of me going out? What was the consequence of me taking 5 minutes to sit in the garden with a coffee? And it took about 3 weeks, I think, before I realized that I was still living in that state as if I had my parents there with me. So really recognizing the problem, accepting the problem, and knowing and being willing to do something about it is the first step. Acceptance is about accepting your feelings in the moment and being willing to sit with them, being willing to work on them, and just being willing to notice them without judgment. And when I say work on them, it's not really working on them, it's allowing them to flow through you, just sitting with them and realizing what they are, that they are only feelings. It's kind of like taking a third position on them, and that feelings, we can choose from one moment to the next how we feel. Sometimes we allow our feelings to control us, when actually we do have full control over our feelings, though sometimes that doesn't feel, it doesn't feel like it. So yes, and knowing you do have full control over your feelings, and that just sitting with them, just allowing them without judgment, can actually allow them to dissipate. And that can be a really powerful turning point. One of the techniques used for trauma is something called pendulation, where you move from that anxious feeling and you move into your heart, into a safe space within your body, because you remember what peace feels like. And if you can sit in kind of a meditative state and allow yourself to then feel the anxiety, feel it in your body, notice where it is within your body, whether it's around your throat, in your jaw, wherever it is, whether it's around your stomach, and then notice peaceful feelings when you're most at peace, when you're feeling really safe and comfortable. Where is that feeling? In your stomach, in your heart, wherever it is, just to feel it, to turn up the feeling, to allow it to be escalated within your body, allow it, you know, to really turn up the volume, if you like, on that feeling. And just how it feels, where it is, you know, if you could see it, what would it look like? Would it, you know, would it be, have a shape? Would it have a depth to it? So really tuning in to how that comfort feels, how that safety feels. And then taking a moment to go back and move to that anxious feeling again. And playing with that anxious feeling, sitting with it, and then maybe turning the volume down, maybe making it kind of smoky, and sitting with it, and then moving back again to the safe feeling and sitting with that for longer. And using this technique, you can really relax the grip that anxiety may have on you. If you do it over and over again, you get faster and more efficient at using the technique. So when you do feel really anxious and you understand that the anxiety is uncalled for in that moment, that it's not really a threat, you're not in a threat situation, that you can work with that and use the pendulation to move into calm and security and peace. But action is our third step, and this is where the real transformation happens. So once you're in that pendulation, once you're using mindfulness techniques, you can then decide on what action you want to take going forward. So if you're anxious about a situation, when you're in that calm, safe state, you can tune in to what's the highest, most powerful action step that you can take, move forward. So for instance, there's a lot of anxiety that people have around public speaking. Is the action that you can take is while you're in that peaceful state to visualize that public speaking event's going really, really well, that you're standing on the stage and you have this assured, peaceful state within you. You can feel it throughout your whole body and you absolutely know that your speech is going to go amazingly well. Can you take that action to feel into it and to build that knowing within you, within your unconscious mind, within your body, within every cell of you, so that you're practicing how you will feel when you eventually step onto that stage? Can you really get into that visualization? And can you apply that to any other anxious events you might be worried about? Can you actually realize that it hasn't happened yet, but you have the power to choose to see it going really well, to choose to see any threats being dissolved and things working out for you? And the more you practice that, the more you attract that. Again, it's your training, your reticular activating system to look for something different, to look for a more powerful and positive outcome. And the lifestyle changes in terms of taking action, you know, taking the time to build this positive visualization and positive meditation and this pendulation into your day, and noticing when you feel anxious that you can step back and take 5 minutes just to practice these techniques and notice that they change your life completely in terms of how you engage with the world, how you visualize the world, and what you think about in terms of your future. And it allows you to choose happy and to promote happiness and to change your energy. I've been practicing these techniques for a while now, specifically around some of the trauma I hadn't even realized I'd taken on while caring for my parents and other events that had happened in my life. So I've been using the pendulation and I've been using the visualization to really sit in that space of knowing that all is well, of safety, of peacefulness, of relief. And that allows me to change my energy, to visualize things turning out for me, to knowing that the universe has my back and everything, life is for me. It allows me to feel happier and to notice, you know, increasing that awareness, to notice the choices I'm making each moment, and that I can choose happiness. I can promote happiness in my life. I can choose to love what I'm doing. I can choose to see that something is going to go well. So remember, it's not about you'll never feel anxious again. It's about what you do when you are aware that you're feeling those anxious feelings, that you're projecting negativity into the future, that you're living in dread and you're shrinking your light rather than expanding your light. You always have a choice. It's about practicing and becoming adept at the awareness part and then the choosing what you do with those feelings, those emotions, that were allowing them, and then using things like pendulation, like mindfulness, to choose something different. So as we wrap up, I want to leave you with this thought. Happiness is not a destination, it's a practice. Every day we have the power to choose happiness, even in the face of dread and anxiety. It's not always easy, but it's worth it. It changes everything. So thank you for tuning in to the Choosing Happy podcast. And if you found value in today's episode, which I hope you did, especially as we're moving into even rockier times, please share it with someone who might need to hear this message today. And until next time, remember, happiness is a choice, and you have the power to make that choice in every moment, in every single day. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this week's episode. If you enjoyed it or think it would be valuable to others, please do share. And if you really enjoyed it, please leave me a review. It really helps the podcast. All of the links are in the show notes, and I look forward to seeing you next week on the Choosing Happy podcast.